us together. You understand that?
Yes, sir.
You understand that?
Yes, sir.
Listen, good.
What's up, man? People to wake up in Chicago.
IUIC. We in here.
Look. Yo. I'm prepared to ride for my people. Prepared to go to war for my people. I'm prepared to die for my people. Cause we the Israelites, we ready to fight. I'm prepared to ride for my people. Prepared to go to war for my people. I'm prepared to die for my people. Cause we the Israelites, we ready to fight.
See, we've been living in hell, if you can't already tell. Glorifying ghettos where they force us to dwell. Either that, or we fill up the jail. Cause ain't no truth in the land, neither is there any knowledge of self. Let's just keep it real, I'm trying to pull you out of the dark. I done seen a murder rate go up off of the chart. We pull a gun on each other, unloaded and spark. And then the police shoot us, we do nothing but mark. Ain't no justice for family and kids. Cause most of us blind, can't even see who our enemy is. They don't know what their identity is. Babylon, a great mystery. I show you where insanity lives. It's a calm before the storm, and I know this for sure. They stole everything from us, and they
pick them up and set them down.
Pick them up and set them down.
Pick them up, set them down.
Pick them up, set them down.
Come on, let me hear you in the front.
Let me hear you in the front.
Let me hear the back.
Let me hear the back.
Let me hear you in the middle.
Let me hear you in the middle.
Let me hear everywhere.
Let me hear everywhere.
Let me hear you everywhere.
Let me hear you everywhere.
Let me hear you say.
Let me hear you say.
Left and right, left and right.
Left
your
right,
left your
right.
IUIC tight. IUIC tight. Yes, ma'am. I can read. You said what? What about the women? Where are they? They're at home. We don't bring them out to war with us. You say what? What do you have for an example? I'm going to show you again. Read this verse to me. 1 Timothy 29. I'm going to show you an example, sister. Read.
The book of 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 9. In like manner also that the women.
The who?
The women.
So the women are the subject of this scripture. Read.
Adorn themselves in modest apparel.
Sister, do you know what modest apparel is? Give me an example. When you go to the bathroom, right? If it doesn't say men and women, what lets you know whether it's the men's restroom or the women's restroom?
That the women have on the dress.
Right. Do you have on the dress right now?
No.
Read that again.
In like manner, also, that the women adorn themselves in modest apparel.
Modest apparel is a woman wearing a dress down to her shin or lower.
Right.
You understand? That's my superb. Give me Deuteronomy 22 and 5.
Bring it out. We're going to bring out
the laws of God so you can know how to serve him. Because he gives you instructions. He gives the men instructions. He gives the women instructions. Right. Let's read that.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 22, verse 5. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
So the Bible says the woman shouldn't wear that which pertaineth to a man. Let's read on.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
So a man shouldn't put on a woman's garment. Right. Read.
For all that do so are an abomination.
Now we're going to read this from the top and break it down. Read it again.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 22, verse 5.
Pay attention.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
When you go to the restroom on the sound, remember, what do the women wear? So if you saw him with a dress on, would that be okay with you?
It would be okay with me, but that's
okay. So, read it again.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
Read on.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
Read on.
For all that do so are an abomination.
So, if you both are wearing, God doesn't expect you to wear the same thing.
Right.
If the man has on pants, is a woman supposed to wear pants? Exactly. That's simple, isn't it? Because that's an abomination. So right now, the Most High is looking at you as you're cross-dressing. But you didn't know. So that's why we are here telling you this. Do you see yourself on this sign, sister?
Yeah.
Yeah, give me Zephaniah.
Hold on, wait. I thought the D was is like, where are the women amongst you? And you say you don't bring them out to battle with you.
But
and,
I'm here.
And you went to the scriptures to find something for her. But
give me Deuteronomy chapter 3, verse 18.
What you can't do, but what her thing is like,
if the
women, like you, we all as a people have the responsibility to bring in our brothers and sisters, right? So where are the sisters at to bring in the other part? It's, all she's saying is all brothers here.
Right.
That's what you
say,
where's
so
the
like, women? Read that. Watch this. She asked, you asked the question, why aren't the women out here? Read that.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 3, verse 18. And I commanded you at that time, saying, the Lord your God has given you this land to possess it. You shall pass over armed before your brethren, the children of Israel, all that are meet for the war. But your wives and but your wives, right now we're at camp formation in the middle of a spiritual war.
That's
we're
right.
fighting
right.
for the minds of our people. Read. But your wives.
But your wives, read.
And your little ones.
And your
children, read. And your cattle.
Uh-huh.
For I know that you have much cattle shall abide in your cities, which I have given you.
So they stay there while we are at war.
That's right.
You understand? We are in a spiritual fight right now. Right now you're wearing pants.
Say one thing, I want to just, brother, I was listening to the side you said. Basically what you're saying is that what the sisters need to show the other women their roles by the example. Let me go into the Bible and show you, because it's a good question. And to answer the question, my wife, our wives, they're at home.
They're the foundation.
I've learned over the years to slow down. I don't want to rush the conversation. It's a good conversation. Let me show you what the word says, okay? Because it's a valid point. And we speak according to the Bible. If I want to show you the example of what a man is supposed to wear and eat, I can show you through my example as well as in the Bible.
Right.
Let's get the book of Titus. Because our job is to edify. We're not trying to destroy our people's spirit. In fact, we're trying to build them up.
Right.
There's answers to every question you have is in the Bible. All we have to do is open it up. Titus 2. Listen good. Come on.
Titus 2. But speak the things.
He's already rushing. I'm going to have him slow down too. Let me look at it. Titus 2. Let's start at verse. We're going to start at verse 3. And I know T.D. Jakes, don't let him bamboozle you. Okay. Well, all right. I understand. Listen good. Come on.
The book of Titus, chapter 2, verse 3. The aged woman likewise.
Stop, because an aged woman, through her years of experience, is able to teach the younger women. For example. But a lot of women, they don't want to stick around. They make a lot of powerful statements and then they move. If you got all that knowledge, come share with us. Our people don't want to learn God's word.
Right.
They're quick to give lip service, as was I. Read.
That they be in behavior as becometh holiness.
So let me ask you a question. It says that the aged women, let's put a number on, let's say 40. The sisters 40 and above are supposed to set the guideline for the younger women, right? Just like if I'm 40 years old, a lot of these young men out here could be my son. I could teach them how I live according to the Bible by my example and my walk every day. And I could show them, our sisters, this is not the place for them, to be honest with you. Watch this. This is what they do amongst the congregation, amongst our children and the body. Read it again.
The aged woman likewise, that they be in behavior as becometh holiness.
Now behavior means your actions, the things you do to display. For example, I was getting on some of the sisters earlier, not trying to be mean-spirited, but when you look at the behavior of the way many of our women dress, it is not holy at all. Let me give an example. I'm going to say Sister A in Cincinnati. We're not even talking about Chicago, so no one can get offended. In Cincinnati, there are a lot of black women that walk around showing every part of their body.
That's right.
And that is not holy at all. Because the way we find out what holy is, by examining God's laws.
Right.
Hold that. Give me Romans 7. I'm going to show you step by step. Because we fish for men and women. We don't try to shoot them in the water. We try to fish them. So you can learn the commandments. And we can stop the confusion in the black communities.
Right.
By applying God's laws. starting with us men first,
right,
and then the sisters. When they see strong men in place, y'all gotta follow us.
That's right.
Watch this. Come on, read.
Book of Romans, chapter 7, verse 7.
I learned once I got older, I stopped rushing. When we rush, see, I was raised by my mother. She used to always try to rush me through everything. But I learned as I got around, brothers, take your time. Let's let the word speak. Wait, come on.
The book of Romans, chapter 7, verse 12.
Remember it said the behavior that's holy. The Bible defines holy behavior by this. Read.
Wherefore the law is holy.
So what is holy, sister, according to the word? The law.
Right.
Read it again.
Wherefore the law is holy.
I'm not interjecting anything. I'm letting God's word explain itself. Read.
And the commandment holy.
So not only is the law holy, but the commandment is holy. So let me ask you a couple questions. Can you give me a couple laws that you've heard about in the Bible? I'm going to ask several of you. What's some of the laws that you've heard, sister? Thou shalt not kill. It's not Chicago. There's a nickname called Chirac. And and I know y'all from here. It's because the murder rate was higher than the rate of the casualties in Iraq war.
Bring it out.
So murder exists here because the Israelites, we're the Israelites. We have not applied, don't hate thy brother without a cause, and then we murder each other at epic proportions. Read it again.
Wherefore the law is holy and the commandment holy.
For the laws of God and the commandments are holy. That's the guideline or the basis. Read on.
Right.
And just and good.
And they're justified and they're good. Go back to Titus. Now we get some understanding of the behavior that our old women are supposed to display so they can teach the younger women.
But if they're at home, how are they going to do that?
That's perfect.
And then you got the women. Brother,
let me ask you a question. Can you allow me to slow down? My blood pressure gets risen when you stress me. All praises. Listen good. I'm getting old. I need you to help me. Great, come on.
The book of Titus, chapter 2, verse 3. The aged woman likewise, that they be in behavior as becometh holiness.
So the behavior that the aged woman is supposed to teach, what's her name? Mama. Okay, you're gonna come right back. Read it again.
The aged woman, likewise, that they be in behavior as becometh holiness.
So now, where's he at? So the brother's gonna explain the behavior is defined upon God's laws. So there's a way that I'm gonna say this. A woman is supposed to dress a certain way. She is supposed to eat a certain way. She's also supposed to do certain things she's not supposed to do. So that's what we're showing you. Because if an older one says she's 45, then when the 17-year-olds one come up, they're not dressing in spandex because the mother is dressing in a long skirt. She's not showing all of her 36 double Ds. She's got loose clothes. So the young sisters are not walking around dressing with tight clothes. They're learning from their mothers to dress modest. And that's what the brother's going to go into. Go into that.
Give me a Ezekiel 16. 44. I'm going to read this for y'all mothers real quick. Because the most I got everything covered, like the captain said. Everything is covered in the Bible. But like the captain said, an example we need, the younger women watching you older sisters. You understand? And God going to explain it to you. Go ahead.
This is the book of Ezekiel, chapter 16 and the 44th verse. Behold, everyone that used this proverb shall use this proverb against thee.
So everybody who used the proverb going to use this proverb against us, the Israelites. Go ahead.
Saying, as is the mother, so is the daughter.
He said, as is the mother, so is the daughter. Kawhi. The daughter is looking up to her mother to be an example. So the daughter gonna do what the mama do. A mother wear tight stuff, the daughter wanna wear tight stuff. The mother got five boyfriends, the daughter gonna wanna grow up and have five boyfriends. The mother married, working hard, doing something, the daughter wanna grow up and do the same things because the mother that example. Read that again.
Behold, everyone that useth this proverb shall use this proverb against thee, saying, as is the mother, so is the daughter.
So that's what they're going to say about us. As the mother is, so the daughter going to be. As the son is, as the father is, so is the son. The father gangbanger hanging out, we going to teach the son to be a gangbanger to hang out the same way. It go both ways. Not just with the woman, with the man also.
All right, that was beautiful what the captains brought out. So give me Psalms chapter 19 and verse 7. So what we're out here teaching is repentance and how to act according to the Most High God's laws, all right? Because those are the things that are gonna fix our people. All of these other things like marching and things like that, that's not gonna help us out. Let's see what God has to say about it, read.
The book of Psalms 19 and verse 7. The law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul. The testimony of the Lord is sure, making wise the simple.
So God's laws are perfect. There is nothing wrong with the word, the laws of God.
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to Join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC to stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.